Hello guys, welcome to my channel at all. Today we will learn how we can interface any remote with Arduino. Now any remote means TV remote, home theater remote, AC remote and etc. This is the sixth video of our how to interface series. Use that I button to access this full playlist. And if you watched this video till end, I am pretty sure that then you will be able to interface any remote with Arduino successfully. So now let's see what's inside this video. In this video, we will see how our remote system works, then its programming with Arduino, and I will explain this program line by line. Then I will show simulation and circuit explanation. Then at last, we will make a small project. So now, let's start our video. How our remote system works. In simple terms, when you press a button, IR light is emitted in your space and IR receiver catch it and use it accordingly. Like this, an IR LED is present in front of your remote and actually it looks like this. But we need to program this, so we have to learn this little bit more. So actually, when we press a button, a predefined data goes to driver circuit of remote and this driver converts it and send it to IR LED and it emits this data as infrared light. Now this IR light reaches to IR receiver and it converts this light to signal and send it to Arduino through a digital pin. Then IR library converts this to meaningful data and display it on serial monitor. Now for our project, we are using universal IR receiver so that it can receive signals from any remote. Generally we use TSOP1838 or VS1838 IR receivers for our project. But I will suggest you to Google these part names before buying. Now let's move to circuit diagram and pin configuration. You can see that when we keep that half cylindrical part upside, then first pin is out, second pin is ground, and third one is VCC. Now after this clarification, we will move to circuit diagram. So this is a very simple one. VCC and ground pin of IR receiver is connected to 5 volt pin and ground pin of Arduino respectively, and out pin of IR receiver is connected to pin 2 of Arduino. Now let's move to programming. So here is our code. First of all, we have to download IR remote library. So for that we will click on sketch, include library. Now to download this, please keep your net connected to your PC. Now here type IR remote. Now you will get that IR remote by Sheriff. Just press install and your library is installed now. Now we can move forward. Now here in line 3, we are using a function of IR remote library and here 2 is written inside it. Actually here we need to write Arduino's pin number from which we are connecting IR receiver. So this line means we are connecting IR receiver from pin 2. Now in next line, decode underscore result is the class and R is a variable. Actually you can write any variable instead of R. And here R will store the value that we need. Now we will move to setup. In setup, we initialize serial communication. Then in next line, we are initializing the pin from which our IR receiver is connected. And this function comes from IR remote library. Now we will move to loop. Here we initialize the variable X of integer type. In next line, we are checking that our result is equal to actual decoded value. And if it's true, if condition will be executed. And inside it, we are taking the r.decode value in x variable. Actually r is the object and value is variable inside decode underscore result class, and decode stores the actual 32-bit decoded value, and now we are getting that 32-bit decoded value in x variable. And in next line we are printing the value of x, means the data we are getting from our remote. And then in next line we are using IR receive dot resume function, means our program is ready to take another input from our remote. So this is the code. Now let's move to simulation. Now I'll press start simulation. Now if I press a button, we will get a value accordingly. In this simulator, I can only use this remote, but actually in real life you can use any remote and you will get a value for each button. And now what we will simply do, we will use different button values to control different output devices. And here I will show you how I can control one LED from this start button of our remote. Now when we press this start button, we get 255 as output. Now we will use if else condition to off and on an LED using this start button. Now here I connected a LED with pin 3 and initialized it in code. We used a global variable of integer type and its name is y. and here we are counting for how many times our power button is pressed. And then we use the if else condition, where for every odd times our LED will be on and for every even time our LED will be off. I can use simple ways here, but in every video I'm trying to show you different techniques. So now let's see our simulation, then we will move to our project. So here you can see that we are able to control our LED successfully. Now we'll make a small project where we will use different buttons to control different output devices. So let's go and see. So let's see the features of our project. Here we will be able to control the speed of motor through volume plus and volume minus key of our remote. And we will be also able to control some LEDs from button number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 of our remote. So now let's see our project. Now you know the features. I will also show you the simulation, but you have to write the code and submit in comments, and I will tell your names in next video. So drop a like and give a feedback in comment section. Okay guys, enjoy this fast forward video. In the last of this video you will get the output. Okay, signing out.